check engine, I also got a VCM code, and this is what I think is happening. And you may actually fix it without replacing anything by yourself if this top gear, plastic gear, it's not yet stripped. This is the motor and it has a metal gear. What I think is happening almost every time is there is a link with several joints, and that link or one of those joints gets stuck, and also perhaps the flaps that are inside the intake get stuck. However, the good news is almost always when something gets stuck, if you wiggle it enough time, it will get unstuck. So that may be a very good news. When these things get stuck, the motor depends how stuck they get. My engine is still driving perfectly well. Just the check engine. I did not drive it after the check engine. And I did open, you could tell perhaps, the plastic gears. There is one, two, and third at the bottom, difficult to see. I'll explain in a moment how to clear the plastic gear access. The top gear, it's perfect condition. What I think happens when something gets stuck after the VCM, obviously the plastic gears will no longer turn. The motor, this is the electric motor here, with the metal gear will try to force on the plastic gear and will start stripping the gears. And by the way, is this, you can just, the two top gears, the bottom one is fixed. You can just slide the center one out of the shaft, and then the top one, they just come out of the shaft. Basically, you will start wiggling and feel if it's rough. When you finish, it should be easy to move. Basically, there are two movements. First, you can try to, let's see here, wiggle it like this. Maybe this is the one that you'll see, there's a bit of movement. This is the white piece, but this is just smaller range. It's not the full range. What you see here, it should go further away. Always, always really careful how you handle this. Don't force on those knuckles, pivots are, plastic pieces. The damage is going to be a little bit difficult on the wallet. So I did remove with all these things, and the two hoses pushed down. I keep down this box. This thing comes out, and now I can have sort of a movement. How I was doing this, really careful not to force. For me, it's a bit stressful at this point because it can get stuck. Then you force and you hear a crack. So even just doing this way, you see those pivots are moving, especially the two top one are moving, and this is a wiggle. That's the knuckle, plastic knuckle is moving. So this is one of the movement you can do like this, gently. The other, oops, let's try to put this back in place without forcing. Okay, got it back in place. The other movement is to keep this crushed even more and just move it, get it inside here, keep this crushed even more. It will create a gap here, and just try to move the bottom of it left right, and you will see that arm will move left right, and you will see the white piece moving all the range. That's the whole idea. And keep doing like this until it's smooth, until it really moves smooth. So you need to keep with one hand pressing here. Careful not, you know, you have these clamps, so you don't puncture the hose. Be careful with this. Maybe put something on the hose here. With one hand, crush down, and with the other hand, we will have some movement at the bottom, some range, and that's how we just try to get those things unstuck. Always try to move the full range, and at that moment, the inner flaps will also move the full range. Hopefully, unstuck it, and hopefully, at that point, when you finish this wiggle, it will just feel free and easy to move. Some friction, perhaps, but easy to move. That's the whole idea. Again, maybe first you want to check the gears, but removing the cover is more difficult. So try to wiggle like this first. My VCM did not get the clicking sound. So, you know, Volvo, that's my older car. Hyundai is diagnosing this also by hearing a clicking sound. That clicking sound means these gears cannot rotate. Something is really stuck in there. and this metal gear is keeping on the plastic one. So maybe when you hear that clicking, maybe it's already stripped here, I don't know. But if you don't hear clicking and you still have engine power normal, maybe you just want to keep the cover in place, don't remove it, just wiggle those things and try to make them move freely. Okay, so hopefully this helps you guys. It looks like it's a recurring issue with this, and it's not necessarily because of the unit itself, it's really those links, or maybe there is some gunk inside the intake. Keep in mind, if you break anything here, it seems you will need to replace the whole intake and VCM, and that's well above $1,000, from maybe even more, $2,000, I don't know, depends on the country too, I'm in Canada. And maybe put some plastic, I don't know, a bag or something like this to prevent the dust getting into those joints. An update, I've been driving it for a couple of time and the code is gone, the check engine is gone, and I must say that after I did reconnect the battery, put everything back in place and fire up the engine, the check engine was gone and my code reader did not show any code, so I did not had to erase any code or reprogram anything, it was just gone. And until now, engine power is absolutely normal and no codes, no check engine lights. Now, it's not necessary to remove this cover. Let me just show you a little bit of the mechanism. And I'm not going to tell you how to disconnect the arm. Actually, what you see, that link from there, that's actually the big, big problem for everyone. Let me just perhaps guide you for just a couple of seconds. So we do remove, this is a 2.4 non-turbo GDI. We do remove this, the three plastic screws. Then we do remove the battery, 40 millimeter clamp in front, disconnected. You just wiggle the end from this hole where is the air filter. Then we need to remove this tube, air tube, two clamp screws, unscrew them enough so you can slide it off, push with a flat screwdriver because they kind of stuck, but be sure you unscrew it enough. Then another clamp hose, air hose, again use a flat screwdriver, toss it from there. Now, VCM, we are going to start by unplugging the connector at the top. There is a tiny clip, just lift it with something sharp, like a Sharpie, lift it carefully so you don't break it and slide it carefully to remove the connector. VCM is secure with three 10 millimeter, I think, one, two, there is a third one, I'm sure you can see it, but you will, is right there, this one here, the third screw bolt, 10 millimeter for the VCM, you just get the socket somehow on the side, or maybe try to get a smaller socket in 1/4 drive and be sure not to strip it. It's not too tight, but just be careful how to access it. You see, I did put a cloth here. It's really tight. And when I did remove the screw, I keep a finger in them so they, I don't drop them down there. They are lost into the space. So be sure to put a cloth just for you. And then once you toss, you remove the three screws, you still have the cover in place. You can pulse it a little bit. I'll explain in a moment. Be careful because the links are plastic. So be careful how you handle it. And then we want to toss this. From my understanding, this is fuel line. So you don't want to try to disconnect in any way. Leave them there unless you correct me in the comment section. Once you toss a little bit, just toss it the VCM from there. Toss it a little bit to the side. Then you get access to this. There is a screw, a plastic screw. That holds a bracket for these hoses. So this way you can toss these hoses, and that screw, it's fairly small. I got it with a 5x16 socket. So it's a small size, weird size, I'm not sure. 8 millimeter maybe. Now this screw, when you put it back in place, you need to put it first and then the VCM bolts. And also there is a lining pin right here at the top, which I cannot film, but on the bracket side, there is a hole at the top. So you need to match those two, otherwise it won't sit flush. Not sure if you can do it. Let's see. Oh, there you go. So the pin is at the top, the hole on the bracket side, it's also the top. Be sure to align them, place that bolt, and only then put the bolts on the VCM, because you won't have access here unless you have a 1/4 drive socket. We have a second bracket, which I think, yes, it's this bracket here, which goes there. It's a 12 millimeter. So with these two brackets, you can toss these lines. There is another bracket, I think is this one, difficult to access, that has another screw underneath. Difficult to put the socket in. Maybe you need to remove this part, this piece to get that, if you want to tow some more. The lines also, if you happen to drain the coolant, it will be amazing to get this hose out of the way, but otherwise you don't want to disconnect it, obviously. And what I did here is that with some care, so you don't puncture this hose, you can push down on these lines, push down on the hose as well, toss them like I could just jump them in the place. So these are tossed one side. This gives you access finally to our beloved VCM, which failed first time at 10,000 miles, and now second time check engine at only 40,000 miles. Thank you, Hyundai. So at this moment, the VCM, you can actually just slide it from there. Again, plastic connectors, really be careful how you move this thing. If you break it, you know what's happening. And we have a few range of movement. I'll try to show you what's happening in there. Let me just get my indicator. So we have this sort of white piece, which has a range of movement. And by the way, I think this is the infamous clip which breaks all the times. To me, it looks like it's one metal piece like a C. On the other side is the same as what you see on this side, but access is impossible. On the other side, even here, is very difficult. And it appears to have two tiny plastic tab, top bottom. So basically when they pressed it in place, they pressed the metal piece and it locks into those tiny tab. I have no idea how you pull it from there without breaking those tabs, and maybe there's another two tabs in behind there. So I have no idea, but you don't need to remove it for what I'm going to show you in this video. What we want to do, let me try to film first, see if I can get an idea. Try to get my light in there. Okay, we see here, we see the two front pivots. Yes, thank you. The two front pivots, this is the pivot that comes out of the bottom gear, the gear that it's fixed. I should tell, it's right there somewhere. So this is one pivot. Then there is this second pivot, which is metal on metal. I'll explain what I mean by that. Then we have sort of a metal rod, which gets molded into a plastic rod. And at the end of this plastic rod, I cannot film it, it's a knuckle. It's like a bulge on plastic. So this plastic rod here locks into the white piece there with a plastic knuckle. And then this white piece also rotates like this. It has a range of movement, which I cannot show you in this video, but when you are going to move these arms, all the range, you are going to see the full range. And that's what you need to do. Move that piece, the full range. It has kind of two stops at each end. Move this plastic knuckle, which is underneath, and move, rotate this, wiggle these joints, two joints. I also suggest maybe try to spray some penetrating oil over that white piece to clean it, because there is a lot of dirt that gets in there. Try to spray penetrating oil on that plastic knuckle as well. You will see the knuckle, but it doesn't show in the camera. Same for this. Actually, don't spray anything on the top here, because it does get at the plastic gear, and I'll explain what can be the problem. This pivot is metal on metal. I suggest you put directly one droplet, but spray something like penetrating oil, but then put a droplet of engine oil to prevent it from rusting and getting harder to move. This one, my suggestion, perhaps put a droplet of oil or very little penetrating oil. Maybe penetrating oil is better, because you don't want to get oil inside the unit. Why? This is the cover here. I'll explain in a moment how to get those. There are six tiny T10 Torx, which I did put on a socket that is 1/4, I think. Yes, 1/4, 3/8 inch drive, but 1/4 the size of the socket. Just jam it so you don't drop it inside the engine. Cover looks like this. And at the bottom of the cover, this is, I think, movement sensor, three movement sensor, which I think they look at the bottom gear, the third one. So you don't want to put any dirt on this. And also don't put lube on those gears, because that lube or oil may just get on these sensors and then you have a problem. Obviously, you also have two contacts. You may want to put a fine sandpaper in between two, because copper corrodes, gets oxidated after a while and doesn't make proper contact. The top, the corresponding pins are this one and this one. Okay, I think we've done. Oh no, yes. To get access to the top, it's easy. To the middle screws, you need to get into this hose here. The other one is easy. For the bottom screws to get access, I cannot do it for you now. I did lift this a little bit and literally crushed the hose with the other hand and put the VCM to sit on the hose. And this way the two bottom screws for the cover were exposed. I had access to them. To get the cover off, also just push on this top connector, because it may feel stuck a little bit. Just push like this. And be sure when you unscrew this tiny screw, keep them with one finger, put one finger on them so you don't drop them. Access is not easy if you lose them. Maybe if you lose one or two, it's not too bad though. When you put back the cover, insert it first correctly at the bottom, match it correctly, and then insert the top. So separately the top, because you really need to observe those two metal pins tabs to match with the ones on the cover, so you don't bend them. And then you just press the top. It's a bit hard because those pins are tight. Just make sure you don't bend the pins inside. When you put the VCM back in place, you will notice that the top, rear, and bottom bolt hole do not match, only the front ones. What you want to do, put the front bolt, screw it all the way in, no gap here, but don't tighten it. You want to be able to pivot it. And then what you want to do is find a spot right here at the bottom of the VCM, right by the bottom screw of the cover, and push towards the rear of the car. And you will notice, actually, it will activate the gears inside. It's a bit hard to push, but be sure this is in place. If you don't align it, you may break something, and be sure you push only on the bottom. So let's just try it. I'm pushing rear near the screw. You notice it's really tight. See what happens. The holes align, both of them, and you can hear perhaps the gear. Those are the gears inside. And just with the other hand, keep it like this and place the bolt in there.